Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to Asgard and welcome back to Like Clay. So if you recall, we made it to the Hall of Trials last episode. So we're gonna go ahead and push on into this area here. All right. See, these elevators are slow as Christmas everywhere you go. They're kind of creepy though because I keep thinking. I keep thinking there's gonna be something standing in the elevator whenever it gets there. Getting darker. We're starting to get that vignette effect. What's this? Is that like a tree growing through the... Yeah, it's like trees coming up through the concrete. Good. God, there's spiders on the windows. I think Shore really wants us to join him, I think. Registration. Prison. Good. Good, wonderful.
My dear friend, it has been brought to my attention that some of our members don't understand that the Chamber of Fire won't open for them until they have walked on the path of Shore and studied Shore's holy relic. Remember that we have to guide our flock.
Okay.
Members wishing to advance to level 3 have to pass a test. The testing device has been installed in my apartment on the fourth floor. If a member is deemed worthy of level 3, please give him or her a key to my apartment. The instructions for the test can be found in my apartment.
Okay.
Based on a hidden note that someone found, we know that we have about 3 or 4 traitors in our midst. We will deal with them one by one and destroy every message as we find them. Please keep your eyes peeled and report suspicious activity. Apparently some members are afraid of Shore spiders. Please let those people know that the spiders won't harm them. Well, unless they sin, of course. If they see someone getting attacked by Shore spiders, that person is a sinner, and therefore the attack is justified.
Good.
One of our members was attacked by Skull, and the only defense that we have against him is our faith in Shore. If someone gets attacked by Skull and there is no priest around to help him or her, I suggest self-punishment. Punishing yourself in the name of Shore should send a strong message to Skull that you will not fall for him and that you are indeed a child of Shore.
Good. So we just beat on ourselves.
My dear friend, it has been brought to my attention that some of our members don't understand that the Chamber of Fire won't open
okay.
for them.
So anyways, we've got, it says 4 keys are still missing. Please return them ASAP. Guys, this is getting really tiring. Shame on you. Okay, I guess there's... I guess they're stealing locker keys. So maybe we can find them and use them. What's... Okay, let's see what about the prison... Prison's locked and that's locked. Okay, so I guess we're going this way. The Walk of Shore. Okay, let's take, let's take the walk of shore, I guess. This just leads. I guess we're gonna go down through here. Min 5 per day. What's this? Maybe we're supposed to walk it 5 times? You think? That's a big spider down there. Oh. Okay, I think we're supposed to run it. Because that spider will get us. Okay, so I'm just gonna sprint around this thing as fast as I can. I'm still trying to keep an eye on... Okay, yeah, I wasn't supposed to... The spider came up because I took too long. Oh, that spider's right there. What? Okay. Okay, I guess we go this way then. What's a spider right there? Oh, I like the eyeball down there. That's great. Okay. Oh, and there's steps. Okay, there's steps right there. Ha! The Chamber of Fire. They said that wouldn't open, though. For us. What's this? 4428. Right. Yeah, it's like 4428. Okay. That must be the code to some Study Shore's holy relic. Okay, we got a key to something, and then we got a note here. We've added you to this conversation because there's hope that you can be saved. Who are we? We are a group of level 3 and 4 members, and we have seen the true face of this cult. The high priest is insane, and this voice that he heard, which told him about Shore, exists only in his head. All this talk about love and happiness is only here to lure you in. Once you're in, however, it gets more and more difficult to leave. Once you're level 4, you'll be brainwashed to the point where you start hearing and seeing things that are not real, and it will be impossible to leave this building. Level 3 members who tried to run away were chased down, dragged back here, tortured, and killed. You're expected to torture yourself in the name of Shore, and one day the High Priest will ask you to commit suicide in the name of Shore. Even the tests that you have to pass to advance in the cult can be deadly. You have to flee before you know too much. You will find more messages in the locker room cabinets. Don't use your real names. P.S. One of the keys is hidden in a book. Kevin. Well, then why does he use his real name? we got another key here. And we got one of these creepy tape recorders.
Is it not beautiful? A piece of art. This sacred relic that you see here once stood in Shore's holy temple. He built this with his own hands. I want you to study it. I want you to look at it for hours on end. If you stare at the relic long enough, you will be enlightened.
Okay.
Why do we have to walk for Shore? After Shore was sent to Earth by the Old Ones, he spent many years wandering around. He was looking for a place to settle down. He was looking for people that would believe in him, that would bow down to him, that would worship him, and accept him as their new Lord and Savior. But he found no one.
What about you?
The people were too blind to see him for who he truly was, a god amongst men. And thus he was wandering, year after year after year, until after many years Shore stumbled into a village that was suffering. The people were starving. Shore cast a spell and fed the hungry. It was then that the people saw him for who he was, a god amongst men. They worshipped him, they bowed to him, they built him a temple, and Shore could finally settle down.
So, I think I had that going while there was stuff going on, but like those faces popped out of the relic. And then Shore was saying something. I guess it was Shore who was speaking to us. I do apologize about that. I didn't know that just looking at it. I thought I actually had to go up and click it. But no, just looking at it did it.
Why did we build the Chamber of Fire? Why should we suffer for Shore? Well, Shore suffered because of us. Shore loved all the people in the village with all of his heart. But to keep them on the right track, he had to impose very strict rules and codes of behaviors on them. If someone broke one of his laws, he didn't punish them because he hated them, but because he loved them and wanted to keep them on the right track. But the people in the village didn't understand this. They soon forgot how he saved all of their lives, and one day they burned down his holy temple to the ground while he was still in it. And that is the reason why we have to suffer for Shore, to get closer to him, to feel what he felt when mankind abandoned him.
Okay.
Is it not beautiful?
Okay.
A piece of art.
So what about
the sacred relic that you see here once stood in Shore's holy temple? He built this with his own hands. I want you to study it. I want you to look at it for hours on end. If you stare at the relic long enough, you will be enlightened.
I just stepped in like a gas chamber.
Be good shape and follow your beloved Shore.
So that's the Chamber of Fire. You may now leave the Hall of Trials.
You are a sinner, and now both Shore Spiders and Skoro are hunting you. You will be dead soon. Dead and gone.
What? I can't go this way? What? 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 Okay, close that door. Thanks. Oh, we got a letter here. This is a dangerous game, we know, Jen. Why are you doing this? What do you mean, Kevin? I've heard that you'll try to convince us to leave this church. Correct, this cult will lead you to your death, and we want to prevent this from happening. Jen. Why should we trust you? It's up to you whether you trust us. We are level 3 and 4 members, and if you decide to listen to us, we will show you the true face of this cult, Kevin. Tell me, what is the true face of this church? The High Priest wants to reawaken a god that doesn't exist and believes that this can be achieved if enough people kill themselves in the name of this god. Somehow these people are then supposed to become immortal, Kevin. I don't believe you. It is thanks to the Children of S'or that I got my life back on track. It wouldn't make sense for them to help me and then ask me to kill myself. You're a liar, Tom. Tom, you are in denial. I'm afraid once you realize that you are wrong, it might be too late to leave. Jen, Tom, don't trust these people. They're in league with Skorl. Remember, the church saved your life. Never forget this. Okay. We've still got one more key. It says four keys were missing. Okay, there's one. There's a note in here. Did you know that there is a level 5, Kevin? How do you know, Tom? I overheard a conversation between the High Priest and a priest. Kevin, how can we achieve level 5? Tom, they won't let you. Only the High Priest is level 5. Kevin, liar. Level 5 is a myth. Why are they not telling us? Samael, the High Priest is hiding something from us. I'll try to get a hold of a key to his apartment. Maybe we can find some answers in there. Kevin, I made a copy of the key to the High Priest's apartment, but I lost it. It should be somewhere in the apartment building above. Make sure to suffer in the Chamber of Fire before you go up there, or else the Eye of S'or won't let you pass. This is another one of their tricks. If you find the key, you can take a peek at the testing device and maybe find out the truth about level 5. Kevin, Skorl appeared in front of me when I tried to leave the building. He started chasing me. I ran for my life. I'm still shaky. Samael. Samael, S'or and Skorl are not real. Jin, what about the earthquakes? They feel very real. Besides, no one can deny that kissing those rings changes something within you. Samael. Okay, so we're still missing a couple of keys. And there's still this. I don't know how to get inside the prison. Is it maybe the same code that 2248? No. Okay. Alright, let's go. Or maybe it has to do with the locker numbers? I don't know, I guess I'm gonna go back in here. Are the spider leggy things gone? I think they are. Those things are mega creeping. Okay, this does just go around in a circle. Yeah, I'm not sure. I think we'll have to come back later on, perhaps. So I guess we'll take the elevator. I'm actually surprised nothing jumped out at us right there. I was kind of anticipating it, to be honest with you. What's this?
Did you expect me to just let you walk away? Sure, spiders are hungry, and they will feast on your flesh.
I love the guy that does the voice acting. Enable power to the elevator. What? Good. Oh! What? What? Oh, they did say that there was a key hidden in a book, right? I do remember them saying that. So let's, I'm assuming that, I almost forgot about that. It's, well, I guess it's not one of these. Oh, here we go. That it? Yep. There's a key. Okay. We probably have to figure out all of this in order to get out of here. Probably find all the notes and stuff like that, so. I'm assuming that this locker... Okay, it is this one. If you still believe that Shore is the god of love, go to the prison and see what his helpers do to those who sin or try to leave the cult. Kevin. Where's the key, Samael? In the safe next to the door, the safe code is 5219. Kevin. Be careful. Watch out for the spiders. They're poisonous. Sandra. Wow, this is brutal. One of the prisoners is not moving. He might be dead. Do they actually kill people? Samael. Yes, I'm afraid they kill people in the name of Shore. Tom, you should take a look too. This will change your mind. Kevin. Samael, are you living in apartment 513? Yes, Samael. What is up with those spiders? They follow me. One of them tried to bite me. I hear voices in my head. I see shadows moving. Suddenly, some doors are gone and I cannot leave. What's happening to me? I'm scared for my life. A priest is following me. I hope it's not too late to ask for forgiveness. Samael. You must flee now, Jin. Your mind is playing tricks on you. The doors are still there. The spiders are not following you. Don't ask for forgiveness. You did nothing wrong. They will torture you. Run away, Kevin. Okay, so it's 5219, and then Samael lives in 513. Just in case that's important. So 5219. There we go. And we got the key to the prison. Oh, good. Good, this just looks a bit jolly. Why'd they do this to me? What'd I just do? Punish yourself in the name of Shore. Dead bodies in there. Okay, I got a key. What do I do? What do I do? What do I do? This is some intense music, but I don't know what I do. What? Good God. How do I punish myself? Let's see. What controls? I don't see any controls. Oh, there's something I could pick up and use right here. Oh, there we go. Gosh! What is this madness? I just grab the nail and just start knifing myself with it. Okay. Well, yeah, there's a dead person in there. Where sinners dwell. I couldn't tell what that guy was saying.
With me,
or something. There we go. There's the last note. The priest caught Samael. I'm afraid they will torture him and try to get him to confess his sins. I hope he tells them what they want to hear, Kevin. Tom, you have to flee. Please believe us, Sandra. I felt Shore's heartbeat. I've seen the spiders. I even saw Skoro. Everything the priest told me turned out to be true. Shore does exist. He is real, and he will return. Tom. You are a fool. We know that you're going through a hard time, but this cult is not the solution. The brainwashing has already started. Kevin, Jen, and I are still trying to undo the damage that they have done to us. We're still suffering from some form of hallucination that is preventing us from leaving this place. Sandra. Tom, how can you be this stubborn? Open your eyes. This is not a religion of love. This is a sinister cult. Kevin. Shore punishes only those who betray him and don't follow his rules. I intend to follow Shore's rules to the letter. He will shield me from all evil. Tom. Tom, I'm proud of you. The High Priest and his priests have helped me in my darkest hour, and they have not lied to me once. I will not sin and betray and abandon them. Besides, I will soon advance to level 3. I've been given a key to the High Priest apartment. Tom, see you on level 3. Awesome. Awesome, awesome, awesome. So the power to the elevator is back on. We did flip that, and that's when the creepy armless legless guy came out.
Help me,
or whatever he was saying. I have no clue. So hopefully now we can get back up there without any incident. Maybe. Okay, color is returning and the darkness is kind of clearing out, so. Seems like we're just about to be safe. Yosh. Okay. Alright, so we made it through the Hall of Trials. Now we actually have to go up to the High Priest's apartment. They did say, what was it, 513? Maybe we can find a key there. Investigate the High Priest's apartment. Okay. The High Priest's apartment is located on the fourth floor. I saw one of the children playing with one of the keys. Okay, there was that. Not sure. We're gonna take the. Oh, that bookshelf's gone. That was here. There's the key. What is going on here? If you notice all the little, like, cutouts, everything is gone. All the doormats are gone. All the little bird things on the walls are gone. All the happy feeling to this place. Plus, the elevator doesn't seem to be working. What's going on? I hate that elevator right now. I've actually got chills up my, like, my hair is standing on end right now. I do not like that elevator at all. T. Krumak is the High Priest, I guess. Oh, great. Would you not look at me? I'm gonna poke that eye out. Okay, wait, we got... Okay, there's nothing in the bathroom. The bathroom is safe. Spiders on the windows. Oh my gosh! Close that. Okay, it says each... Alright, I can turn on the lights. Each of the four weights has imprinted one of Shore's signs. Take the weight of the sign representing the person or servant who is dearest to Shore and put it on the scale. Once this is done, step on the wooden platform. If you chose wisely, the Eye of Shore will open the door to the next holy ring of shore for you. If you choose poorly, the Blade of Shore will punish you. Remember, the dead is Shkoro, Shore's brother. The spiders are Shore's loyal warriors and spies. The trees protected... The trees protected Shore...
Lead us, let me sit on your golden throne. Oh, Shore, my lord and savior.
From those who hunted him during his time of wandering...
Let me drink from the fountain of you. Let me live forever by your side.
The walls gave Shore a home and protected him when he could finally settle down. Spider right there.
I wish to serve you forever and ever.
Looks like somebody got punished. I'm going to assume that it's the spider that is the most important to him. Okay. Okay, that could be very painful, I imagine. But I think the spider is the correct one because the spider's always at the top, if you notice. Like, always at the top. Okay, what do we got here?
We could live in paradise, but our forefathers abandoned Shore, and they betrayed him, and they followed Skoro. This sin has been passed on from one generation to the next, and now it is up to us to suffer. This is why we all are born in sin and must pray for forgiveness. Skoro is still around us. He is trying to seduce us with his promise of everlasting life. But don't fall for him. Don't follow him, for Shore hates sinners, and sinners will burn. Shore loves you with all his heart if you stay on the right track. But if you decide to abandon him, if you decide to follow Skoro, then Shore will destroy you. For Shore hates sinners. If you sin, my priests will punish you. They will push you to your limits. But they don't punish you because they hate you. They punish you because they hope that Shore will forgive you if he sees that you are willing to suffer for him. And maybe if you are lucky, Shore will once again welcome you in his arms. For when the day comes, we will stand in front of him, and he will judge us. And those who sinned and didn't ask for forgiveness will be sent straight to hell, where they will burn for all eternity. Those, however, who prayed for forgiveness for their sins, those who punished themselves in his name, those who bow down to him, listen to his word and love him with all their heart, those will be granted eternal life, and those will sit next to him on his golden throne. We could live in paradise, but our forefathers abandoned Shore, and they betrayed him, and they followed Skoro. This sin has been passed on from one generation to the next, and now it is up to us to suffer. This is why we all are born in sin and must pray for forgiveness. Skoro is still around us. He is trying to seduce us with his promise of everlasting life. But don't fall for him. Don't follow him, for Shore hates sinners, and sinners will burn. Shore loves you with all his heart.
Okay, I guess it's just that one recording that's on there. So we got another ring to kiss. Love only Shore. Alright, let's kiss it. We got the achievement. We got the level 3 member achievement. Okay. Is there anything in here? Oh. New safe code 8614. I'm afraid the group of traitors is trying to convince Tom Kemer to leave us. So far, they appear to be unsuccessful. We have to stop them. The good news is that we caught one of the traitors. He will soon find a new home behind the library. Blessed be Sor, for he is the Lord. High Priest TK. Behind the library. Okay, so it's 8614. What we got here? All. I caught one of the traitors. We will show him no mercy. However, there are more of them. We are currently chasing down this person calling herself Sandra. One of our loyal members met her in the chapel. Apparently, she's a level 3 member. I will deal with her within the next couple of days. She will soon meet her friends behind the library. Blessed be sure. Behind the library. And then, my dear friend, by July 2nd, we have to have at least 30 level 4 members ready. I predict that about 5 of them will fail Shore's final test, leaving us with about 25 members. While this should be enough, I'd rather have more ready by then just to be on the safe side. Therefore, we have to promote our members more quickly than we did in the past. 3 days on each level should suffice. Please implement this new policy ASAP. Blessed be Shore, for he is the Lord, High Priest TK. So where am I supposed to go now, then? Into the library in the basement. Okay. Oh, I was hiding and I missed something, I think. Seems like Shore's kind of popping around at the moment. Why? You gotta follow me around. Why? Entrance ground. Okay, so into the basement. Can I please have lights? Please? Okay. Maybe this one? That's the library. Okay. Well, I know I missed something with Shore. I imagine he was probably floating around. Sorry about that. I was kind of chicken and I jumped in the elevator and all the lights shut off when you jump in the elevator. So I was going to try to like peek my head around and see, but it didn't work out too well. I don't even know why I tried to take the elevator, because the elevator hates me at the moment and it chases me at the moment. All right, find Tom Kemer. And now we've entered the library area. Alright, but I do know that it's about wrapping up point, so I am going to end this episode here before we descend into any more madness with this. So anyways, I hope you guys are enjoying the series thus far. I will say the ambient horror aspect of it's pretty creepy. Ambient horror, I think, is the best. Hands down, it's the best. So, but anyways, if you guys enjoyed the episode, as always, be sure and hit that like button. And go ahead and subscribe if you're not already for more daily videos. And we will pick this back up tomorrow. So until then, as always, do take care, stay safe, and I will see you guys then.